Hello, it's lovely to be back with you again. Hope you're all right.
And we should say welcome to our home.
We should, yes.
Welcome to our home, because we're not in our studios this time, we're in our home. And our home's a bit different this year, isn't it? Is there something different in our house, isn't there, we don't normally have here? Well, the boys and girls have spotted it, I wonder.
We don't normally have this in our house all year round, that's for sure.
No, it's a Christmas tree. I wonder how many of the boys and girls have actually set up for Christmas already and put the Christmas decorations up. I tell you what, I know we can't see you, but hands up if you've got your Christmas decorators up. Now, I'm sure we can't see you there, but I'm sure there's a lot of them.
There will be.
And you know what?
What's that?
I wonder how many of the boys and girls have had chocolate for breakfast.
All of them, probably.
All of them, because, you know, you've got this thing called an advent calendar. And advent is the time that leads up to this time of year that we call Christmas. It's a getting ready and preparing for Christmas. But I bet you there's quite a few mums and dads that have been doing some other things too, like running around shopping.
Yes. Preparing.
Yeah.
Getting the turkey in.
Yeah. Well, not stuffing. In the oven yet. Buying it in. We're not in the oven because it'd be off by Christmas if we did that, wouldn't it? Well, is Christmas really all about all that?
No.
Anyway, we've got something for you to watch, so watch this.
Oh, hello, Susie. I didn't expect to see you today. Hey, it's not long now till Christmas. Do you want to just pop the lights on and let's have a look what they look like? Oh, look at that. I bet you're getting so excited for Christmas, aren't you?
A bit, I suppose.
Oh, what's the matter? Come on and sit down and tell Grandad all about it. This isn't the Susie I know who normally can't sleep for nearly a month before Christmas. I thought that you helped your dad put the decorations up last week.
I did, Grandad.
And I know that yesterday your mum let you help her make the gingerbread biscuits you love so much.
Mm-hmm.
So, what's the matter, Susie, then?
I just don't feel Christmassy, Grandad.
Christmassy?
You know, Grandad, that exciting feeling I have when I think about Christmas Day coming. The lovely presents and the food and the decorations and the films on the television.
Ah, I see. So I see what you mean. But that isn't what Christmas is really all about, is it, Susie?
I've had such a terrible shock, Grandad, that I can't seem to get excited about Christmas stuff. It all seems so unimportant.
Oh, well, why don't you tell me what has happened, Susie?
You know how cold it's been recently, Grandad?
Yeah.
Well, the lake in the park near us iced over completely.
Oh!
It looks, or should I say looked, really pretty.
Oh yeah, go on.
2 days ago, I told Mum that I wanted to go ice skating on the lake because it was frozen.
Oh, and I expect that she said no to that request.
You're right, Grandad. She said definitely not. That is far too dangerous.
And of course you listened to your mum, didn't you?
That's the problem, Grandad. I didn't. When she was busy talking to one of her friends on the phone, I slipped out, picked up my ice skates and headed down to the lake. It was still just light enough to see my way.
I really don't like the sound of where this story's going, Susie.
I had an amazing time ice skating, Grandad.
I bet you did.
And it was so beautiful, with the snow everywhere.
Yeah.
I thought that I was in the film Frozen and any minute Olaf would appear.
Oh, Susie, really?
I was in the middle of the lake, trying out a special jump when I heard this awful noise, a cracking sort of noise.
Oh no!
Suddenly, Grandad, I was plunged into the freezing cold water, and it went over my head, and in my nose and my eyes. It was really scary, and it smelled awful, and I hated it.
Oh, how frightening for you, Susie! That must have been terrible!
It was, Grandad, and it was dark too, and I thought I would never get out of the lake, and that I might die and no one would find me.
Poor Susie. But somebody obviously did because you're here talking to me today. So what happened?
I clung onto the ice and I shouted, help, help. And the next thing I saw was a light coming towards me. I thought I was about to meet Jesus face to face, but it wasn't him.
So who was it, Susie, coming out of the dark?
My dad carrying a large rope with some of his friends. Mum must have told him I wanted to go ice skating on the lake and he came looking for me. He must have guessed I was in trouble.
How did your dad get you out the middle of the lake then?
He was very brave, Grandad. He wiggled onto his stomach across the ice with his friends and he held onto the rope. And then he pulled me out of the water. Once he got me off the ice, he wrapped me up in a big blanket and carried me home on his shoulders.
Oh, your dad risked his life to rescue you, Susie. That lake is very treacherous.
Can you see now why I don't feel very Christmassy?
Yes, I can see. But, you know, being rescued is actually what Christmas is all about.
Is it, Grandad?
It is, Susie. God the Father sent Jesus to earth to rescue each of us because he loves us. But unlike your dad who rescued you from the lake, it cost Jesus his life.
Oh, so what do I need rescuing from?
You need rescuing from the results of turning your back on a loving Heavenly Father, doing what you want and ignoring what he wants.
Oh, I see.
You see, God's plan for our lives has to know him and to walk with him. When we choose not to do that, well, he didn't abandon us, but sent Jesus to show us his love and to rescue us. That's what we are really celebrating at Christmas, God's rescue plan for us.
So are you saying all the food and the parties and the trees and the decorations would help us celebrate Jesus coming to rescue us?
Yes, that's right, Susie.
Well, Pete, I know what rescue has been like. I could celebrate that. I'm going to ask Mum to make me a big chocolate log ever, to buy me a puppy, have a party, put up lights all over the garden.
Susie!
So, Susie was rescued by her dad.
Yeah, he used a rope and some friends to help to pull her out from the middle of the frozen lake. Now, first of all, I must say, safety warning here, do not go skating on any lakes. No matter how frozen it looks, Susie was very silly.
But she was.
Thankfully, she was rescued, okay? That's the first thing, all right? She was rescued from the lake, wasn't she?
Yeah, and as Grandad said, that's what God sent Jesus at this time of year for, the big rescue plan. What does that mean, Mark?
Well, basically, God loves us so much. And sometimes we do things wrong and we disobey parents. We also disobey God, a bit like Susie did, really, disobeyed her mum and deliberately went out and ice skating when she shouldn't have been, right? And it's things that we've done wrong. Now, as Grandad was pointing out to her, that, you know, God had an extra plan for us in sending Jesus to us. And Jesus came into our world, and that's what we celebrate at Christmas time, him coming as a tiny baby. I'm sure some of you, maybe in your schools and maybe at home, have got nativity sets set up, a bit like probably this one here on this picture. As you can see, the nativity scene shows Jesus as a baby. Of course, Jesus grew up, he didn't stay a baby, because you might be thinking to yourself, how can a baby save people? But he grew up into a man, and then when we come to Easter time, we celebrate what Jesus did for us in dying upon a cross. You see, Jesus was given to us, not just us, but us, everybody, as a baby, as God's special gift, because he loves us so much.
And that's why we give gifts to each other at Christmas, to remember the best gift ever, Jesus, given to us by God.
Well, Jesus has a special name, don't we? We call him the Saviour, and another word for that is Messiah. And sometimes we also have another name attached to him. We call him Jesus Christ, okay? Or the Christ. And do you know what? If you think of the word Christmas, if we didn't have Jesus in Christmas...
Or Christ in Christmas...
We wouldn't have Christmas at all, would we?
So we've got lots to thank God about.
We have.
At this time of year. The fact that he loved us so much that he sent Jesus to save us.
So in the busyness of getting ready for Christmas and running around like headless chickens, or maybe headless turkeys because it's Christmas. Sorry. When we're running around, remember the reason why we're doing it. Because Jesus is the reason for the season.
So as well as thanking your mums, dads, aunties, uncles, grandparents for your presents at Christmas, remember to say, thank you God for sending Jesus.
And you know, if we were in schools now, we'd sing that lovely song we always sing every Christmas, Rejoice with Us This Christmas, but we'll put it on as a link at the end of this video. So it's great to see you all again. Have a wonderful Christmas. And so would you like to finish with a short prayer?
Yeah, let's pray. Dear God, we thank you that you loved us so much that you sent your son as a baby to come and rescue us. Lord, help us to remember at this special time of year what you've done for us, not to get just all excited about the gifts that we receive or the gifts that we may give, but also the big, best gift that you gave us. So Lord, I pray a blessing on all the lovely children and the staff in their schools, that you would just keep them safe at this winter time. We ask this in your precious name. Amen.
Amen. Well, have a great Christmas, everybody, and we'll see you in 2022.
Bye.
Bye for now.